The street is rather cautious, or everyone's wondering what exactly is there an ALM mismatch in the first place? If you could tell us that.
No ALM mismatch for the?
For the company.
No, we don't have an ALM mismatch at all, because as we have mentioned time and again, that it has been a fundamental principle of our business for the last 30 years that we don't do any asset liability maturity mismatches. So therefore, we are all fully matched. And that, as I said, that it is a fundamental principle and the role of the company that we don't violate that. So there is no problem on the liquidity or on the ALM side at all for us.
What is the outstanding by way of liabilities, say, for the next 90 days?
Actually, that is something which is, I will not be in a position to just comment on exact liability, but whatever the liabilities are fully matched with the asset recovery that we are having. So, as I said, that and it's always a surplus. So, that's the position that we have. So
there is a surplus, actually.
There's a surplus because we have never borrowed from the mutual funds in the short term to do lending ever in SREI's history for 30 years. We have never borrowed short to do business. So therefore, the entire matching is there, that when we take term loans, we take ECBs which we are raising up in the international market, plus the NCD, and accordingly we do the business. So on the asset side also, we have various tenure, starting from 1.5 years going to about 5-6 years. So it is all but fully matched on the liability side.
Okay. So what is your borrowing mix then, if you could give us some clarity out there?
So borrowing mix, basically everything is for us medium to long term. So we don't have any short term borrowing.
Okay.
And medium to long term, which is there, is constituting of loans from banks and financial institutions.
That would be bulk of your borrowing from banks and financial institutions?
Not bulk. It is well matched. So there is a mix of about 50, 25, 25. So we have about 50% from the banks and institutions, which are on term loans, etc. We have 25% with the ECBs, then we have medium to long-term bonds. So that's how the mix of the liability is.
Okay.
So the buzz in the market is that borrowing has become difficult for SREI Infrastructure. So if you could just throw some more light on it, when was the last time you raised borrowing from any of these, you know, banks, ECB or medium-term bonds? And in the future, do you need to raise some more money? And if yes, what is the current cost of capital for you if you go to the market right now and raise some money, borrowing?
No, we are continuously raising. I don't know where this all these rumors are, because and these are unfound rumors, because we are continuously raising ECBs, which is ongoing almost every month. We are getting some disbursements from the ECBs we have tied up. We are taking term loans, etc., from the banks which are there. We have been raising NCD. We just closed one NCD issue about 2 weeks back. We are going to launch another
quantum of that
issue.
The recent borrowing, and at what borrowing rate are you doing it?
No, because as I said, that you see, the entire borrowing for us is based on the asset side of it.
Okay.
Therefore, we don't borrow and just keep the money.
Mm-hmm.
If you just borrow and keep the money idle, that would not be a wise
move. Fair enough, sir. I agree.
So the borrowing and the asset.
So just give us a sense of what is the borrowing cost? Yeah, the borrowing cost, what was it? You said you raised money just around 2 weeks back. So what was the quantum and what was the borrowing cost?
So I'll have to come back. You see, it is not
a rough number, sir. You would be aware of a rough number in this sort of a market when everyone's, you know, struggling to raise money. You're sounding rather confident, which is good news. The share price is telling another story. But you could, you know, explain to us that the quantum, at least, of the money that you've raised at what borrowing cost. Go ahead.
Yeah. So like this month also, we have raised about close to 1,500 crore, and on the liability side. So with term loans, with basically ECBs and with the NCDs that we have raised. And plus the cost of borrowing definitely has gone up by about 100 basis points in the last two quarters especially, I would say. And after the ILFS episode, it has gone up by about 1%. And
What is the cost of borrowing right now for you, the last borrowing?
So it would be close to about 10%.
10%. So what is the collateral that you are offering? Because again, I'm just, you know, going by the buzz in the market, is that perhaps you're now offering real estate as a collateral?
No. We don't have any real estate financing, so we can't offer real estate. That is, again, wrong rumors. So, it's very difficult to comment on rumors.
That's fine, sir. Just if you could deny it then, that...
Yeah. So, we don't borrow against real estate because we don't finance real estate. So, therefore, there's no borrowing against real estate for us.
Is it tougher for you to borrow today than it was, say, a month ago?
No, I would not say it is tough. But we have gradually, we have also taken, because in the view of the present market conditions, we have been also going slow on our disbursements. So we have not been doing much of disbursements which we were doing last year before September. So we have slowed down our disbursements, and it is a prudent policy for us, because you see what happens, that in the last 30 years we have seen that many times the markets are shaky. So that particular time you don't have to just keep on pressing the accelerator and growing. So that's the reason why we have consciously taken a decision. We are absolutely in a very comfortable position. The asset liability is there, or where the business is concerned.
So you're saying is that you are borrowing less because you're also going to be lending less?
Yeah.
It's not because it's tougher for you to borrow and therefore your growth is going to slow down?
No. You see, basically today in the present environment, the borrowing cost has gone up, as I mentioned. So therefore, it will not be wise to just keep on borrowing and lending, because then we'll be putting the balance sheet to risk.
Right. Mr. Kanoria, you're talking about things have been shaky in the past, etc. You know, what's really taken a hit is your stock price. If I pull up a one-month chart or one-year chart, actually, I tell my producer to pull it up for our viewers as well. And investors out there, they're getting very, very shaky in terms of the company. But you're telling us that, you know, you can raise capital as and when you're not having a big issue
You can raise money.
You're borrowing, that's had no impact whatsoever, though your borrowing cost has gone up by 100 basis points. So give us a few numbers then. If your borrowing cost has gone up by 100 basis points, that'll impact your margins, right?
No, it will not again.
It's passed on?
That's why I would suggest, because again, I would suggest that if you just put things into the right perspective, we have always been talking that and mentioning from the company that we do not take two risks. One, asset liability mismatches we don't have. Second is on the interest side also, all our borrowings, whatever it is there, is passed on to the client. So when the interest rate increases, we pass on to the client.
Okay. Sure.
If the interest rate reduces, we pass it on to the client.
We get that point, Mr. Kanoria. Just quickly, you know, your quarter four dispersal were how much? Around 5,000 crores? 5,500 crores?
Yeah.
How much has it slowed down to?
But we have now been slowing it down. So I think that this quarter also we should be, I can't give you the exact figure, but it will not be to the same tune that was in the last quarter, because for two reasons specifically. One, on the infrastructure financing itself, we have been slowing down for the last 3-4 years, and we have declared it time and again to the market. On the equipment financing side also, because now the new government has been formed, the same government is going to continue. Mm. Last 3-4 months, not very many contracts were being awarded, because our equipment finance growth is in proportion to the contracts which are being awarded by the government for infrastructure projects. So we think that from July onwards, new contracts will get awarded, and then again the equipment financing growth will start happening.
But some approximation, sir, from 5,600 crore of disbursements in Q4, in Q1, would it be in the ballpark figure of 4,000? Would it come down to 5,000 crores?
Approximately.
4,000 crores.
Yeah.
All right. What about on the asset quality? Because that deteriorated very sharply in the March quarter. So from 10.3%, it increased to 14.6%.
So basically,
is that worsening?
No, it is not worsening. Again, you see, the provision that we take does not mean that it is a loss, because again, our business model is a little different. That what we do is that we are financing against equipment. We have made extra provisions in the last quarter. That has been more of a conservative and a prudent policy which our company and the board decided to take in view of whatever has been going on in the NBFC and the present environment. But for us, we are financing equipment. So what happens is that when we make a provision also, we can repossess the equipment and sell it. Mm. And it is not that, and we have been doing it for the last 30 years. So we have the repossession capabilities, we have the reselling capabilities, we do online sales, physical auctions of the equipment. So when we make a provision, it is not a loss. So actually, if you look at our balance sheet, then you will find that whatever we have provided is not a bad debt.
Okay. Mr. Kanoria, you know, want another clarification. There was talks that, in fact, the number of employees had come down drastically. I'm talking about attrition. Give us a sense. So give us a count. How much has it come down?
Numbers, it would have come down by about 10%, 10 to 15%. We have gradually, because as the business has slowed down, it would be but obvious for us to also reduce the cost down.
Okay.
And what about a SREI equipment IPO? I know we keep asking you that, but there hasn't been much progress on it.
But how can you see this particular market? It will be stark raving mad for us to announce an IPO for an NBFC.
So because when
the sentiment is so low. So the sentiment is so low, so we will wait for the appropriate time.
So it's indefinitely postponed, sir?
No, it is not indefinitely postponed. As I mentioned, we'll wait for an appropriate time. Everything has to be done at the appropriate time. So we don't. It's not that we don't have the capital for the growth, etc. So capital adequacy ratios and all are very comfortable. So that is not a problem. We have to do the planning, and capital markets, you only tap when the market is good, not when the market has a negative sentiment of the entire industry.
You know,
and we are not in isolation.
Mr. Kanoria, talking like an investment banker right now, good that you know you have reasoned out and you understand that the market conditions are not great, because going by your share price, you know, it is down 70% in the last 1 year or so. So maybe, in fact, you're making the right decision to not do it at this point of time.